Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to show you how to change or replace the LCD on Samsung S6, the normal one, not the edge one. So as you will see in this video, this is not going to be an easy video, an easy job. Unfortunately, in my opinion, I think and I find the S6 normal and the S7 normal the most difficult one to replace the LCD on it. This LCD is not brand new, has been refurbed in our company, so it will be a good LCD anyway. Before anything you do, make sure you test the phone so you've got all the parts before you close back the phone, because this phone is not easy to reopen after you seal it back, you know. So make sure the test works, everything, you've got signal, you've got volume workings, unless you change the bezel. If you change the bezel, don't worry about the keys. Okay, I'm not gonna show you how to remove the back cover, because I've got a special video about it, which it will be in more details. Because sometimes what people does is they just break the back cover off because they are made of glass. But in the video which I made it, it will explain you how easy it is to remove it and put it back. The same one, because it has the original IMEA. If you buy from aftermarket, they come without IMEA. It's just a Samsung logo on the back and that's it. It's just a copy back cover, but it looks better if it's the genuine one. So very easy to remove the bezel. Just take, it's like 16 screws I think, just remove them. And the very important thing after you remove the screws, don't try, if you want to reuse the LCD, if you want, let's say you just want to change the board or something, or make a rip on the board and you want to reuse the LCD, make sure you hit the front LCD just for about 20 seconds, no more, 20 seconds for 100 degree, because what you want to do is just to separate the bezel from the mid frame which supports the LCD. If you don't pay attention on this step, your paint from the actual front glass will come off. As you can see, now it's not even hot enough, so it doesn't affect the glass. It's just gonna affect and melt a bit the front tape. There's no way how to remove this in the best way, but what I would suggest, you start from the top side, never from the bottom, because the bottom is charging port, where is the jack connector as well. So that one is gonna block a bit the mid frame to come up, you know. So this is the best way, start from the top, it's much easier. Now at this point it's quite easy, you've got the board in front of you, disconnect the battery, disconnect the LCD connector, all the parts. As you saw in the beginning, my LCD comes with a no mid frame, so it will be difficult, because what you need to do is just to take everything out, clean the old glue and just put a new glue, new tape, everything. It's quite difficult because you have to realign the LCD, you know. But in some cases there are many shops and many labs where they just buy it straightforward with the mid frame. It's much easier, you know. Before anything you do, as I said, this was an LCD which I previously gave to refurb room. So what I want to make sure is that it's still fully functional. Which is most important, it's not necessarily the image, it's important is the digitizer, so it works, you know. That's which you should be concerned about, you know, because the rest of the functionality phone you can test it afterwards, you know. But touch is most important. If you see any point jumping or something similar, like it doesn't connect, or when you take your finger it's not going straight, don't use it, because the customer will just bring it back, you know. As you can see, I use my tweezer, which is a really sharp tweezer. If you're a beginner, I would suggest you not to use tweezers, like metallic tweezers, nothing with metal, because you can damage the PCB, the board, which might be more difficult for you to repair after. Just take a plastic tweezer or a plastic tip or something similar. Well, another important thing, while you work over the phone, make sure you cover somehow the back camera and the front camera with some foil so it doesn't get dirty, because if you want to clean it after, you might use some contact spray which will leave spots on your camera. So then you need £20 just to buy your back camera, because it's not cheap, you know. You can leave the charging port while you connect, while you change the display, but if you find much easier, just remove it. I mean, I think in this one you can't remove the charging port unless you take the front LCD off. So what I'm gonna do now is not 20 seconds, I will use more heat for like, I think might be a minute, I don't really remember, but no more than a minute. And you use it in like 3-4 steps. You hit the LCD, start from internal, you know, and step by step remove the LCD off. First is battery. I use this plastic card, which is quite easy to find, not difficult. If you find it hard, just put some spray underneath the battery, it will come off really easy. With a 7-inch, it's most sure that you're gonna need some spray to remove the battery. Make sure you remove the old tape, because if you're not gonna remove it, it will create like a gap in between the battery and the mid frame. And the problem with that is it will push back into the bezel, which will push back into the back cover. So in time, the back cover, which you're gonna put it back, is gonna come off. Which, to be honest, you don't want that. So you can use a different tape. It has the same size. It's under 1 millimeter. So just make sure you use just one tape. Don't put it on top. You know, that's very important. Sometimes I put my name on the phones I do, because a lot of customers, they just change the display or do something with the phone and just bring it back, say it's a faulty phone or something like that. But first you have to make sure it's your phone. So as you can see, I'm starting from inside and as well in the outside. Why I'm doing this is because we will see in the next step. You have to cut first the tape, the adhesive tape. That's very important. Make sure you don't pry too hard with those cuts, because it can cut the flex off. So take it step by step. If it's your first time or while you're doing this, it's just best to use it like 30 seconds, hit the LCD, then make one simple step, you know, then make the other side another 30 seconds, hit it again, you know. Because what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna definitely reuse the LCD. Yeah. When we have people coming for interview and they saying like, I've got 11 years experience as a technician, a phone technician on electronics, the first thing I do, I'll just give this phone. If they can do it, they're definitely good, because this is not an easy phone to do. It's much easier to change the A6H, A7H display than this one. It's easier if the LCD is just completely broken, because you don't really care about it. You just rip it off and that's it, put a new one. But in this case, if you still want to reuse the LCD, which is really, really thin, you have to make sure that your technique is really good, so it's not going to damage the LCD. Because this LCD, as I remember, it's at least £120, minimum £120. So if someone just come into your shop and just start ripping off all the LCDs, that's not going to be profit for you, isn't it? This job, I think it takes you up to might be 30 minutes, might be something like that. As I said, if you're just a beginner, take your time, take like an hour and do it proper. Because in time, after you do one or three phones, you'll just do it faster and faster, you know? This job, to be honest, it's a really nice job. What you need the most, if you wanna be the best technician, the best phone repair technician, is just have patience and start thinking how to develop your skills, you know, like how to improve your skills. If you've seen this video, for example, and let's see, let's say you've got a better way, just let people know, you know, it's much much better. That's why there's YouTube, so we can share the information everywhere in the world, so everybody can have access to it, you know. How otherwise we will evolve, you know. While you're separating, as you can see, I used some sort of a spray. It's called Falcon 530, but you can use it's basically it's like a contact cling spray, which is really really dry. It's not gonna affect the board. It's not gonna leak under the chips or under the parts or under the camera. As long as it, oh no, when it has the first time contact with the air, it's just gonna disappear. It's gonna dissolve quite fast. So that's really good if you wanna remove the glue or like the old tape, which is really sticky. Just put some spray there, cloth, and you can remove it straightforward. So, well, make sure there's no dust in there. Try to remove the earpiece mesh, which is the metallic one. Take off all the dust what's in there, because that's the only way you can clean the dust in there. There's no other way you're gonna do it. So step by step, clean the old tape, because you're not gonna put the new LCD on top of the old tape, because you're gonna use a new adhesive. If you don't have another adhesive, I will suggest you not to use anything else except the original one, or at least something similar which is the same size as this one. Don't use a double tape. Just use it's called a B7000. It's a silicone glue specially made for LCDs, and just put like a small pinch in the corners, and that's it. Don't do it. Don't put it where's the home button, because it's gonna leak underneath the home button. It's gonna be stiff. And that's it, you need to do it all over again. You know, sometimes happened to me because I used too much glue and it leaked under the home button just a slightly bit. And one side, like the left side of the home button, was really hard, and the other side was clicking, which is not a proper repair. So what you have to do is just reopen everything. And the technique I'm gonna use to put back the LCD, it's a really, really strong technique. It will be really difficult to remove the LCD off, you know. So make sure everything it's as it has to be. As you can see, I removed the home button. I'll make sure that there's no dust in there, or there's nothing wrong at all, you know. So that's really important. As you can see, very easy. The most difficult part is already done, is to remove the old LCD, which you want to reuse it, you want to refurb it. The rest is quite easy. You don't actually need to realign somehow. There's no special tricks how to realign. Just put the glue, the tape, and with the earpiece mesh, the LCD flex, and the home button, it will realign by itself, you know. Very easy. Very easy, but in the meantime, it's a very difficult job to do it. Not that easy. The most difficult part about this S6 is, let's say you want to change just the home button. Let's say the fingerprint doesn't work, but the screen is not cracked, and you want to reuse the same LCD. Then what I'll suggest you is try not to use too much temperature, because when you put too much temperature, the paint, which is the gold in my case, will just come off as a aluminium foil, you know. It's not that strong connected to the glass. It's just somehow pressurized with some sort of a liquid in there. But when the temperature hits the glass, it'll just fade off, you know. That's really, really why a lot of people, when they change the LCD, and they just rip it off, you know, because it's quite difficult to change the glass if they, you know. And same story with the back cover. If you wanna know how to do it, how to take it off without damage the paint, well, just go on my channel, or maybe I'll put in the description link below how to refurb, how to change the back cover. You'll see it's more important. So before anything, as you can see, this is quite a dirty LCD. It has glue all over it. You know, what you want to make sure is just the front camera has no spots in there, so it will be a proper phone. I use the same contact cleaner, the Falcon 530. There's actually also another spray which you can buy in Italy and Spain, I think, and I think it's made by Germans as well. Or definitely it's by German. It's called G22. You can get that one as well, but it's more expensive. It's like €28 I paid for it, and it's just like 300 millimeters. Very expensive one, but it's a really strong one. Falcon 530 is made by Chinese, so it's definitely gonna be something similar, but it's not the same substance. The best way to put the tape is to start with the bottom, with just one corner. If you somehow manage to align successfully just one corner, all the rest will just align by himself, you know. Really easy, nothing difficult, nothing to worry about. So as you can see, start just with one corner, try to align the corner, the other one, and that's it. Rest should be really easy. Make sure, yeah, very easy. Nothing complicated. So like I said, the most difficult part is just over. What you need to do now is just put the LCD back in the mid frame and just try to reconnect all the boards, all the parts, all the bits back together. Put the bezel back, make sure everything is working, and that's it. It was quite easy, but the most difficult part, as I said, is just to remove the LCD. So this one is the B7000, or the other version is a Yaksun Y7000. What I'll do, be careful, I'll put the glue all over the place except the home button. Don't try to use too much glue with the home button, and don't use it too much with the top flex of the screen, because if you want to remove it, it'll be really damn difficult to take it off. Believe me, because I did hundreds of this kind of phones, you know. Moment, this is the best option which I have, the best technique which I have. Make sure you clean the earpiece, as I said, so there's no dust in there, because if there's dust, it will it will put like a pressure point on the earpiece, which in the end will sound really crackling, you know, like really really bad sound. You might think it's the earpiece damaged, but it's not earpiece, it's just the dust which is pressure. Put pressure on the earpiece. So you know, it's like a step by step, small parts which you have to follow. You know, if you follow everything like as it should, you know, you'll be everything fine. If anyone has a better technique, just send me a link. I will check it. You know, I'm always open to learn more. So as you can see, what's most important before you seal everything back is just the home button is clicking. There's no leaking or glue coming off. Or make sure there's no glue with the front camera, because that will be really a problem for you afterwards, you know. So starting this point, this glue, the silicone which I put it on, In like 5 minutes, it will start to dry really, really bad. If you can't put it back the phone in 5 minutes, what I'll suggest to you is just use some clamps, like cloth clamps, and start putting some pressure on the midframe with the LCD together, so we'll glue it back. You know, leave it like that for like 20 minutes, then try to fit everything back together. But in my case, I'll just do it straightforward. I'm not gonna wait too much. I'm just gonna put the bezel back frame, and that's it. And then I'll put on top of the heat plate for like another 20 seconds. So I'll just try to melt just a bit the glue, which I used in between the LCD and the mid frame. So that's it. Quite easy. Nothing difficult. I've got so many phones which I want to fix at home, but I just don't have the microscope. So unfortunately, I can't do really like a proper how to replace a BGA or how to clean the bulb, how to diagnose the bulb. But in time, when I'm gonna buy the microscope, I'm gonna do that as well. You know, I learned electronics, to be honest, since I was 16 years old. At the moment, I'm starting engineering, so I've got loads of techniques how to repair phones, how to repair boards, quite a lot of stuff, which a lot of people can learn from. So make sure you connect the aerial cables back. One thing about those two cables, if they don't click while you put them back, it means there's no proper contact, so you will lose signal. Maybe your phone will get like only two signal lines, so that's not what you want. At the end of this video, I'm not going to show you how to put back the backlash. As I said, I've got a special video about it. It takes too much. It's like a long time to do in just one video, and so I decided it's best to do it in like two or three videos separately. So you know, sometimes people are just looking for how to replace the back cover, and that's it. They don't really want to look through all the video. So if everything is back together, there's nothing to worry about. Put back the bezel. Just screw like the top and the bottom, like two at the top, two at the bottom screws. Because it's really important that you got connection with the speaker. If there's no speaker connection with the board, it will be something really interesting happening in your phone. It means your amplifier, you will supply output signal to a high impedance, you know, which will overheat the amplifier, which will like really it could damage also the sound IC, you know. So if there's no speaker, definitely your chip will gonna hit really fast, you know. So that's it. What you want to know is just, as I said, screw everything back and make sure that everything is working fine. Nothing difficult, as I said. You can use quite anything to clean the fingerprints on the glass. There's no like a special solution. You can use even alcohol. So this is the foil which I'm gonna put on top. Normally, I put it while I start my repair, just to make sure that I don't get scratches all over the screen, because it has to look like a new phone. But for this phone, I haven't replaced the bezel, neither the back cover, so it's not gonna be a grade A. It's just gonna be like a grade C, maybe. You know, it's just a new LC. That's it. That's it, guys. Really easy. Now make sure everything works. Put a SIM there, make a phone call. Volume, everything. So you see, very easy. Nothing difficult. Make sure the sensor works as well, because sometimes while you replace the LCD, you don't align it back proper. So if you close the phone and the proxy doesn't work, that's gonna be a problem. So that's pretty much all. So that's quite all. Microphone as well. Charging port. This will show you if you connect back the charging port proper. Yeah, simple phone call to E. It works. And that's it. Now it's time to go back to back home, and that's it. Before you put the back cover, I'm gonna tell you something really important. If you haven't removed the old tape off, remove it off. Make sure there's no sticky stuff in there, because it will push back. Even if it's like a small pin there, it will push back into your back glass, so it will look really bad. Make sure everything is clean. But this one is already clean, because as I said before, I did a different video which I spent like 5 minutes just to clean the bezel. Very easy, using a red double tape, and you can cut it off as you seen in the picture, at the same size as the back cover is. And that's it, really easy. If you do it perfectly, like really proper, in a proper way, it will be waterproof as well. You can test it afterwards in water, and definitely gonna work. If you're not sure, just put like a Mobi 7000 around, just like one line from one point to the other point, like a circle. That's definitely gonna work even better. So that's it. As you can see, it looks like a brand new phone. Everything nicely done. What you're gonna do now, if you, as I said, if you haven't done it in like 5 minutes, put on a heat plate to just melt a bit the glue, and use these clamps, which is like $1 or £1. And that's it. Leave it for like 20 minutes, and the job is done. Okay, guys. If you liked it, if you enjoyed, please subscribe. It's free. No, nothing to pay for it. Cheers, guys. See you in the next video.